Hey, look, I'm really excited about this week's podcast. Somebody we haven't had on before, somebody who most people in the fitness industry will know who it is. Keegan Thornhill is here. How are you, mate?
Yeah, I'm really well, man. How are you?
Oh, I can't wait for this one. This one will be fun. I've had a lot of people asking to get you on. It's time. Let's rip in.
Welcome to the Body Science Podcast. As always, the information contained in this podcast is for the information purposes only and is not designed to diagnose or be prescriptive to treat, prevent, or manage any injury, disease, or other health-related condition.
Welcome to Body Science HQ, the world of fit, happy, healthy. And I'm going to chuck on the end of that, Indomitable Crew. That's a big word.
Indomitable Crew. Yeah, it's a mouthful.
It is a mouthful, mate. How did that come about?
Well, indomitable, it means like he who can't be subdued or overcome. So me and my business partner, we've kind of had a bit of a rough go over the past. So it kind of just become a word we really related with and started what we call the indomitable movement, which is pretty much just trying to get that whole mentality of overcoming obstacles and sort of bringing that athlete mindset to a lot of people.
I love that. So there's no missed sessions at your place, I'm assuming?
No, man, never.
So for those people out there that aren't aware of what you're at, you're a body recomposition and mindset specialist. Is that a good way to put that?
Is that a way to put it? Yeah.
Yeah. So what does that particularly mean?
Well, I don't think anyone really knows, man.
And that's why you're an expert, and that's why you'll always be able to charge. And I congratulate you on that. For anyone out there who's looking to start a business, that is a good strategy to start with.
Yeah, create your own niche. That's how you do it.
Exactly.
Yeah, well, I got into like the whole bodybuilding world and then become a body recomposition specialist. So obviously that's just manipulating people's body composition through training, nutrition, supplementation and all that. And then over the years, started to realize that one of the biggest factors limiting a lot of people was actually their mindset and the way they thought about themselves. So I sort of went down the NLP path, sort of started studying neuro-linguistic programming and that.
Yep.
And kind of just combine the two. So what we sort of do now is like while we're sort of doing the training, nutrition, supplementation, we're trying to teach a lot of the sort of disciplines and the mindset around actually being an athlete and sort of mentoring people into adopting that kind of lifestyle, whether they happen to be an athlete prepper for stage or just a gen pop person that wants to be more successful in life.
And do you find a lot of gen pop coming to you these days to set new goals and create some change for themselves?
Yes. Yeah, definitely. So at first we kind of used to have a bit of a reputation more for being athletes.
Yep.
But I'd say over the especially last 2-3 years, a lot more gen pop start to relate with our message just because they've tried everything before. They've tried the fad diets, they've tried all the quick fixes and just realized it didn't work. And the methods that we preach, you know, it's hard work. You've got to stick to food, but hey, it's actually worth it. They tend to start relating to. So yeah, we've got about 4 coaches on our team. So sort of coach anywhere from 3 to 350 people.
Wow.
Let's say about 30-35% of them are probably athletes that we prep for stage.
Yep.
And then the rest of them all the gen pop that, you know, even though they mightn't be an athlete prepping for stage, we refer to them as athletes. We get them to treat themselves like athletes and kind of just adopt that way of life.
That's a great mindset. That's always been our theory here at Body Science too, mate. Everyone's an athlete. Some phase, obviously, we don't have the accountability button you've got, and that's great. Because do you find that having that mindset, like Indomitable Crew, that mindset is if you're joining us, there is an accountability clause here that you are going to stick to, and would that be a lot of your success?
Yeah, I'd say a lot of it's trying to teach people just to own the shit.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, like we understand that, you know, for someone that's never sort of trained, never sort of dieted, they're not going to nail it straight up. Like they're going to be a lot of screw ups. But as long as they own it, we can then show them ways to work around that. So a lot of what we do is we call people on their bullshit and just keep trying to educate them as well. Here's how we upgrade. Here's how we like look for the opportunities to grow from this.
I love that. I love it. So how do people reach out to you if they do want to jump on?
Yeah, well, like, you know, you've got Instagram, man. Instagram's our big one. So you got myself, I'm the Recomp Pro on Instagram. And then we've got our team page, the Indomitable Crew, where people can find us on there. All 4 of us coaches sort of run that page, or there's my page, which I run, that they can sort of have a chat. We line up a phone call or something.
And are all coaches aligned with the same skill set, or do you all have a varying skill set so that you can cater to more people? How does that work?
We all sort of, we've got the same like base that we sort of stick to, but then we kind of all specialize in our own little area. So myself and James, we're the head coaches here. So we do all the athletes and we prep. I probably have the most disciplined type approach. I demand quite a very high standard for those that I work with. James sort of relates a lot more to the hard gainers and stuff like that. Then we got Hayden and Harley that are more, I hate the word transformation specialist, but it's kind of what they are. They sort of work with our gen pop people, sort of with a watered down approach, what me and James use with the athletes. So obviously using similar mythology when it comes to the training and nutrition, but just a little bit easier approach that they can kind of build up to a more and more disciplined approach.
Man, I love it. And look, I'll be really honest. I think success is built on the premise of what you're talking about. So congratulations on having the vision to take that approach, because there's a lot of people out there that struggle in this industry too because they're just trying to get that next dollar. And it looks to me like you're just as quick to say you're probably not the right person to having the right people on board.
Well, yeah, I think that was always a big thing that sort of cracked me off a little bit about the industry. Like everyone just chasing the dollars, just trying to be a specialist at everything.
Yep.
Whereas we kind of really found our niche. Like, you know, we're here to create athletes. Like if you want to look better, you know, be stronger, have a better mindset, we're the team. If you want to sort of be able to run 5Ks or do a marathon, we're probably not the guys for you because you won't ever catch me running.
I love it. Look, speaking about you, you brought it up. Do you want to go through a little bit about your bio and who you are and what brought you to where you are in life right now?
I've been in sports my whole life. I used to be quite a high-level swimmer. I swam at the 2008 Olympic trials.
Mm-hmm.
Used to actually have an eating disorder when I was a kid. So I'm a quite a heavy person. Like even at the height of my eating disorder, I was about 85 kilos, which is quite heavy for most. For me, it was, yeah, I was very sick and ill. And got into the gym because I was 18 at the time, realized that the guys with muscles were picking up the chicks. Thought that'd be the way I'd go. Got into lifting, played a pretty high level of rugby, then moved down to Melbourne when I was about 25 and got involved in the fitness industry, PT and that, and realized that I probably couldn't play rugby because I'd injure myself. Had a couple of guys at the gym that did bodybuilding. So I was like, all right, let's give it a crack. Did my first show and just fell in love with that sort of lifestyle. I've been bodybuilding ever since, really.
Nice. So, mate, are you sort of saying the whole journey started from you hitting rock bottom? Is that where you're at?
I'd say I've hit rock bottom probably more often than most. I'm quite an extreme personality type. So, as I said, had the eating disorder, went from one extreme to another where I went from trying to get as skinny as possible to trying to get as big as possible. I have worked in the past a lot with people recovering from eating disorders and that. And one of the things I tell them is it's something you never really recover from. We kind of just change the focus of it. Okay. So rather than getting them to stop focusing on being skinny, we kind of retarget their obsession into a more healthy way. So when I had my eating disorder, it was quite an unhealthy obsession. Everyone was worried. But once I started directing it to let's get as big and strong as possible, no one had a problem with it. I'd say it's the same obsessive type habits, but you know, in a way that's actually allowed me to move forward in life. So I had that probably built to quite a decent level of success as an athlete and a coach. And then about 3 years ago, kind of had my next rock bottom, which was going through a pretty nasty separation and having to walk away from two companies and start again. And that's when the Indomitable Movement was actually created.
Okay.
Me and James, we used to work together, lost our companies, kind of had an industry kind of that I'd upset quite a bit. I was quite a controversial person up until that. I spoke very strongly of my views. A lot of people didn't like it. Had an industry that was kind of cheering that I'd hit rock bottom, and me and James decided to see it as an opportunity to really show what we'd sort of learned with the mindset type stuff and completely rebuild a brand from scratch. And that's how we designed the Indomitable Crew.
I love it. I absolutely love it. So what brought that reputation into play? What were you, like for those people out there that, and everybody wants to hear your story because you're successful,
mm-hmm.
and we all want to know what that magic pill is, and we all, you and I both know there isn't one, but we try and talk about some of the things that happened to you too that were your magic pill moments. What helped you rebuild your reputation from that second rock bottom? You talked about you'd had an emotional breakup. That's tough to lose your business is a second level mm-hmm. on that. But you, there was something about you, something in you that rebuilt that reputation to get 350 clients. Like that's an amazing story.
Yeah, man. I just didn't see it as any other option. Like I had a son at the time, really kind of, you know, like most that hit that kind of situation, feel like a bit of a failure. And you're like, well, man, what are you going to do about it? I can sit here and cry about it and do nothing and, you know, be a failure, or I can bury myself in work and actually build something to be proud of. And that's what we did. I chose to look at the rock bottom as an awesome opportunity to sort of build from with no attachments to a past. So up until that time, as I said, I'd been quite controversial in that, and having had to leave two companies and start from scratch, I'm like, I can be anything I want here. I can build whatever brand me and James can sort of sit down and build whatever kind of legacy we want. There's nothing holding us back. And we kind of just ran at that opportunity. And obviously that come with challenges, but you know, you just run at those challenges and make it work.
I love it. I love it. Hey team, it's Greg from Body Science here. The Hydroxyburn Shred is back on shelf. It's our new therapeutic, has all the taste. And if you're looking for a better thermogenic, we've really pushed for the pursuit of a better thermogenic. Full disclosure on the label. What do we mean? Caffeine levels have changed. We all know the rules have changed. The ingredients have changed. The claims have changed. We have a clean label with premium quality ingredients for you. So what does that mean for you? You can look at things like metabolism, energy, sugar metabolism, fat metabolism, cognitive function, thyroid, and just general health and well-being. And it's all on the label. If you're taking a fat burner now and it doesn't say it on the label, have a look at it and go, why? Get on board. Do you think these days when you're obviously, I want to have a chat to you about some of the keys to, you know, body recomposition, like what do you think are some of the formulas here we need to look at? Do you bring your time at hitting that bottom? I know I'm harping on it, but it's such a topic that people want, like you said, there's a lot of people happy to see me fail. You see that all the time in this industry and every industry. And it's just, we're humans. We just naturally think that way, which is devastating, but we also support the underdog.
Yep.
So do you think that you bring a lot of that story that you went through into your, some of the keys to people's body recomposition?
Yeah, definitely. So like the guy that actually did all my NLP certification and that through, he joined our team to see how we use the mindset stuff through the fitness and body recomposition. It was an approach that he hadn't really seen before. And really like a lot of the quotes that we use where athletes to try to get them to align with our message and that, it's, we got quotes like standards over feelings, which pretty much means it doesn't matter what emotional state you're in. Like, you know, there's a standard we hold ourselves to. And these are all the kind of lessons we try to teach in the way we stick to a diet and in the way we train, like, you know, no emotional eating out of the fridge. Like we need to learn that emotional craving for shitty foods, it's not going to serve us. Let's hold ourselves to that standard. So as we're sort of teaching these disciplines through the food and nutrition, people are actually adopting them in life. So we really bury ourselves in that. And I'm a big believer in, like, you know, as a coach, my number one role is to be a role model. So I've got to set such a high level of standard that I don't expect people to live up to the standard I hold myself to. But if I can hold such a high standard, it gives people to keep inspiring, something to look up to.
Nice. What are some of the things that you're doing when somebody signs up with you to change? What are some of these standards that you're putting in play? Just the basics that people can go through and get their head around, oh, wow, I don't do that in my business, or I could do that better, or gee, I don't have that in my life. What type of things are you looking at as the keys to success?
Well, the self-accountability is a big one. Yeah. Like trying to teach people that, like, your responsibility for your own results. Like as a coach, I'm here to give you the information, but if you don't stick to it, I can't help. So a lot of it's trying to find steps that they can commit to at first. A big thing I'd say is people need to be more realistic with themselves. Like what they're willing to sacrifice, is that enough to get to the level they want? Like we see this all the time, especially with athletes. Athletes want to be able to become a pro athlete, but they want the freedom of just eating whatever they want. It's like, not going to happen. We need to be a bit self-aware of that. I'm not going to tell someone they need to stick to a diet as strict as I am, but if you want to be a pro athlete, you're probably going to have to. So that would probably be the biggest thing we expect from people, just the self-accountability and the self-responsibility of owning their own shit.
Is there a big gap between the fitness competitor and the everyday person that comes in and what they're actually looking for?
Not really. Like, not as much as you would think, hey? Like, it's a high level of standard and a high level of commitment needed.
Yeah.
But they all have the same problems. Like, you know, the problem that the overweight person's having with the emotional eating, athletes are having too. It's just on more of an extreme. So I'd say they're a lot more similar than they all think. And that's why we're kind of approach the gen pop people like athletes too, trying to get them to move that athlete status. It's the same problem, just on a bigger scale.
I love it. And do you find that you're having a great connection between people that come to you just to change their lives are then looking at what's the next step for me, and they are getting into that competitive stage?
Yeah, definitely. So we get a lot of people that come. Like 3 weeks ago, we had an athlete step on stage that's gone and lost 60 kilos.
Wow, and congratulations.
So we have a lot that come on, they sort of hit a certain point, like, you know, they might come on and just go, hey, look, I just want to feel confident next summer. Like, sweet, let's do it. They get there and they see a couple of athletes, they see what's involved, and like, you know what, I wouldn't mind giving that a crack. So that's a big thing we're trying to always challenge a lot of the people we work with. Like, there's never an end date with this.
Yeah.
Like, you're not just trying to lose 20 kilos and then you stop. Like, once you hit that 20 kilos, we want to try to test people, like, what's next? Like, are we trying to grow more muscle? Are we trying to get even leaner? Like, what's the next step? It might even be a lifting goal where they might want to hit a certain strength on a deadlift PR or something, but constantly be chasing that progress. It's a big thing that we're always encouraging everyone to do.
I love it. I love it. Mate, so is there, from a business perspective, let's talk about your business for a while. Is it something that is going to stay Victorian? Is it, so if I'm a young trainer and I'm aspiring to grow my brand along with your brand, is that something people can do, or is it a closed shop, bad luck, jog on? What is it?
Yeah, man. It's just how often, say, like, we're getting a lot of pressure at the moment from a lot of people to try, you know, move into state,
yep,
set up multiple locations. Really, me and James just don't think it's a wise move for us.
Mm-hmm.
Like, our brand's kind of really known for the reputation we have.
Yep.
And the culture that we've created within our team. Like, when we go to shows, like, you can always tell our team apart because they all get along. We've really worked hard on creating like a team environment, which is, I think, something that massively lacks in the fitness industry, like, especially in the competing scene. Like, everyone goes there, everyone's desk staring at each other, no one talks to each other, and we just want to just kind of scrap that and go, we're all here for the same reasons. Like, I don't care if I'm competing against you on stage, like, you've put in the hard work, let's all just respect that. So we've kind of got a really good culture like that, and that only kind of works because we're in here. So our goal is kind of more to expand. So we've got a 440 square meter personalized training facility here that's decked out for our athletes with all specialty gear. We're hoping in the next 12 12 months to actually double the size of it. So we've got 300, say, we average between 300 to 350 people. We've got four coaches on board now. We've got a fifth coach starting in 2 weeks. And really, we want to get another three, four coaches on board and, you know, double our membership base and just keep creating that sort of culture and spreading the vibes.
Mate, I love it. I love somebody who knows where they want to go and what they want to do too. Like it's refreshing to hear, believe me. Look, we're going to wrap up in a second, but one thing is, what is the future of this fitness industry that we work in, do you think?
Where the fitness industry goes? Oh, who knows, man? Like it's hard to tell because it's constantly changing direction. But I think the whole pandemic especially has exposed a lot of people to what the fitness industry was and that they were kind of trying to aspire for the wrong shit. And I actually see the fitness industry taking a much better turn now where, you know, people are looking for quality over just, you know, the person that shows ass and tits on social media. Yeah. So I'm actually excited for the direction it's starting to take now. People have started to realize that there is a massive difference between following a social media follower and an actual coach that has no knowledge. They're starting to look towards the industry with find the respectable coaches that are out there. So I'm actually kind of excited to see where the industry goes.
Mate, that's awesome here. You would not believe how excited I am to hear that as well. So if they want to jump online and have a look at who you guys are, Indomitable, that's Indomitable crew.com. That's your website. Look, I can't thank you enough for coming on. I've really enjoyed the chat. I think this will be very popular with people. You are a renowned figure in that competitive space for the other people in fitness that aren't in that space. I think they're going to find what you said really refreshing and probably look with a new set of eyes on what is out there in coaching and people and what's in it for them.
I appreciate the opportunity to get on here, man.
Yeah, mate, let's clock up again soon. We'll pick a new topic and we'll get another one going in the near future. How's that sound?
I look forward to it, man.
Cool. Hey, big shout out to your team. They are really well known for people who don't know, and I congratulate you on the success that you've built. And I love somebody who didn't sit in the corner and cry and go, poor me, and said, you know what, let's go do this. And you did it. Well done.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Awesome. Thanks for coming on board.
Yeah.